My pleasure to welcome another TIE 50 winner from the software space, Kazeon. The founder CEO is Sudhakar Muddu. Sudhakar, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure to have you as the TIE 50 winner, but I want to start with the perspective in the space you are in and how the current economic scenario is taking its toll on the space.
So I think, I mean, first I want to thank you for giving the opportunity, and we're very pleased to get the TIE 50 award. Yeah, I mean, I heard that out of 1500 companies and 50 companies selected, it's very pleasure for us and it makes us very feel proud. From in terms of where Kazeon has gone through, in my life I've seen this many of these up and down of recessions, and I always think of these as opportunities. As the company continue to invest in technology and you're in the revenue stage and you have good customers, I think as the economy comes back, it gives an opportunity for us to build better platform, more questions, and make good companies more stronger as we exit the recession. So I still feel good that we are going through this process only makes companies better and makes us more profitable and grow our revenue.
We also want you to give our audience a flavor of what the company does. We are proud, obviously, to have you as a winner.
Great. So just at a very high level, from a simplistic view, what Kazeon does is we do manage information within the corporations. We are mainly a software company, as you said. We are focused on enterprise customers, and we offer information management tools, i.e. enterprise search, e-discovery. So we provide tools, like think of a way of providing the Google for internet. We provide a Google-like engine for enterprises to search their information for applications such as e-discovery, risk management, security, and the underlying platform is called information management. We look into the content of the documents, interpret the words and the keywords, and provide a conceptual engine. So for example, if somebody were to look for documents in contracts and NDAs and legal documents, we can cluster those documents as they're all related to legal documents. Similarly, if somebody is looking for a word called Jaguar, we can relate to whether Jaguar is an animal or a car from Detroit. So we have a contextual engine. So if you look at the spectrum of how search has evolved, it evolved from keyword to concepts to more relevant engine. And once we have this information, our goal is to provide compliance officers, business users, a tool so that they can do better decisions in managing their businesses.
On a personal note, for you as the CEO founder, what do you think is the most challenging thing for you in the current economic times?
I think the challenge is I think that last recession was this recession. The challenge is it came out of the banking sector, it came out of the financial sector. The sheer perception of the customers is hunker down, not to spend. That's a challenge because people do have the pain point. People want to buy the product, but people don't have the money to buy it. And so as long as the economy gets better and people continue to spend, I think it will do well. But if the economy comes to a point where it has a bottom again falls, or some people talk about a second shoe falling again, that will create more challenges for startups because no startup will have endless money. And we're all operating on a pretty much close to cash flow break even, plus or minus. So for us, it's important to have a recurring revenue growth in this economy.
We're all trying to survive by the day. Personally for you, what is the motivation? What's the drive?
I think the drive is, this is my second startup I'm doing it. So the drive is, I get my fire under my belly is always is, as long as every day we are adding new customers and we're able to make a difference, that it's a lot of satisfaction. I think you want to be known that you have created a product that people are using it. And as you offer this product in millions of dollars of revenue and for the company, that's a great lot of satisfaction. That you create your own baby, that people are using it, and there's a value to the customers. In a way, you're giving back to the society that what you have learned in your experience and your school and education.
You were a technologist before you became an entrepreneur. The transition for some is smooth, for some it's very challenging. In your case, what was the scenario?
I think it is. I think the best thing I tell people is you have to be always a school student of the business or student of the process. Learn. Be very open-minded, absorb information, learn from your peers, learn from your senior people, and the best is always surround yourself with smart people than you. If you have that, you'll always succeed, because when you are an engineer, I call it one of my previous advisors or my boss told me once, the transition is called three-step process, engineer to entrepreneur, entrepreneur to executive. And those three E's has to be done in a very successful manner, otherwise you'll falter.
know, on that note, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you very much. Very nice. Thank you.